Good evening, everyone. Let us start this program with a prayer written by Dr. Rabindranath Tagore. Where the mind is without fear, where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake. Thank you. Hello?
Yes, sir.
So good evening, everyone. Welcome to MedPiper Senior Citizens, Doctors, Public Society, and IMA Chennai Metro virtual Q&A session on COVID vaccine. And so MedPiper aims to increase the awareness on the COVID vaccination and how it can benefit everyone in the long run. And we have found that there are many concerns regarding COVID, its vaccine, its routine procedures, and a lot of misinformation going on, circulating around the vaccination. So today evening, we'd be having all these questions answered. Everybody can also log on to Journomed for, latest medical news and updates on the coronavirus and vaccination. So I'd like to introduce Dr. Kailas Sitharaman, who is a senior physician and chest consultant with a special interest in asthma and allergy. He is the medical director of Asthma Studio in Velachery. He has been in teaching faculty in Madras Medical College and Kilpak Medical College for both undergrad and postgrad courses. And he has obtained fellowship and memberships from various reputed medical bodies. He's conducted numerous medical conferences, seminars, workshops, and currently he's a vice president of IMA Chennai Metro and secretary of Independent Medical Practitioners Association of India. He's also the medical director of Venkateshwara Hospital in Chennai. So, Dr. Kailas Sitharaman, it's your platform now.
Thank you, Suvia. Thank you very much. I welcome all the participants today, all the panelists, for a wonderful session on COVID vaccination. I have the passion of, I started this Doctor Public Society with a specific aim to educate the patients on various issues in medical practice. So doctors used to come and talk to patients on every Saturday. We have this program ongoing. And we have another group called Senior Citizens, where we used to call them and talk to them. So we have clubbed both these two groups for this particular session, because this COVID vaccination is one thing which is the in thing now. Like, everybody wants to get vaccinated, but they are scared to get vaccinated. So we thought we will clear all the doubts of all the public who have any issues about vaccination in this question and answer session. So we have about five panelists here who will question Dr. Sharma, and the chief person who is going to conduct the event for the day is Dr. Sharma VSN Rachakonda. He's an MD, FCCP and FRCP. He's an Emeritus Professor of Cardiology, Rajiv Gandhi Institute, Srikakulam, and is also an adjunct professor, Tamil Nadu Medical University, an excellent teacher. And I've been associated with him for many years. He has been an excellent teacher. He conducts many of our CME programs. Apart from that, he also conducts a lot of other programs for the public, including spiritual upliftment and other topics related to the public. So we look forward to your this session, which will clear all the doubts of our public who have anything to do with the COVID vaccination. So we start off the session with the Surya will start the first questioning.
No, please introduce the panel members. Please introduce the other panel members.
I will
thank start. You for introducing me.
Yes. I will do that, sir. First we have Surya, who's going to talk to who's one of our panel members. Surya Nair is a public relations officer from MedPiper Technologies. MedPiper, as she said, is a community platform for healthcare professionals. MedPiper verifies and connects doctors and healthcare professionals with hospitals and healthcare organizations for duty vacancies, clinical assignments, and partnerships with pharma and manufacturer, and takes part in medical educative program. In fact, they are very kind enough to help us to give that platform for all our CMA programs and for Doctor Public Society and for senior citizens as well. So I will try to introduce each panelist as they ask questions. So first, over to Surya Nair for the interaction with Dr. Sharma. Over to you, Surya.
Thank you, Dr. Kailas. So my first question to you, Dr. Sharma, is do we all need to take corona vaccine, and why?
Before we start off the questions, I have a few things to say, very important things. First of all, let us thank and wholeheartedly appreciate and give our pranams to our national leader, our Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, who is instrumental in making COVID fight as what it is now in India compared to so many other countries. So we start with a very profound sense of gratitude and acknowledgement to the government of India, led by Dr. Sri Narendra Modi and his team of ministers and health minister and the officials and ICMR, NICD, and other important agencies that are contributing for the COVID scenario, how we are today compared to the whole world. So yes, we start off with thanks to them. And needless to say that all state governments also are taking a very leading role and very important contribution from all the people who are in the state governmental agencies, but for whom the COVID fight would not have been what it is we have. The other thing is the doctors and the paramedics and all the healthcare workers who are fighting tooth and nail to bring out the best outcomes for the patients who are unfortunate to get the disease. That's the second important thing. Third, the international community, the fraternity, the scientific fraternity, which has worked tooth and nail and worked very hard to produce a couple of, even more than that, vaccines in a record time. And last year we were just starting the pandemic by this time, and this year we already have the vaccine in many of our bodies, and others are lined up. So what more an achievement there is there for mankind? It is much greater than man landing on moon, I think, and or a Mars landing on man landing on the Mars in the next years. And this is a very remarkable achievement. Not the least, the cooperation of the public. All the people who are very sensible, they behaved very appropriately during the pandemic and saw to it that India, a population of 130 plus crores, only around 1.5, 1.6 crores are affected. What does it mean? It means that the virus is not sparing us, but we are sparing ourselves from the virus. So these are the four agencies which we require to keep: one, the government, state and central; two, the national bodies of healthcare and the scientific community; three, the people who are fighting very hard to treat people with COVID, including the doctors and paramedics, and of course, all the public. So with that note of acknowledgement, and of course, the note of acknowledgement to the Almighty for whatever we are all today, and to my gurus who have been so kind enough to make room for me to be one among the people here, and then discharge my responsibilities with utmost faith and reverence to their feet. And again say, idam namama, even this is not mine. Whatever I am speaking is not my personal experience. It is only from the scientific experience, collective experience of all the scientific community that I'm going to present. And Dr. Kailash has briefly made it with these words of profound gratitude, and then sort of acknowledgement we start off the program, and you can now bring in the discussion live by putting your putting forth your first rather question or doubt, whatever it is. Nair?
So can I repeat the question again?
Yeah, please repeat the question.
Yeah, so do we all need to take the corona vaccine, and is it like necessary? Why?
Yeah, the two questions are involved. Do I need to take, do all of us need to take? Yes, an emphatic yes, an emphatic absolute yes. Why is important? Because here is a disease where the virus is new, and we don't have a proper and approved and scientifically valid treatment. Of course, there are treatments, but we don't have the treatment for this disease. Like for tuberculosis, we have, for HIV, we have, for even influenza, we have a very good antiviral drug, but we don't have a clear cut drug which acts. Number two, one, it is a new virus, spreading fast, highly transmissible. Treatment options are not best as on date, and the methodology we are using hitherto to control the corona is how? By putting the mask, by social distancing, and by hand washing, sanitization, which are totally behavioral. We know there could be a slip in these behavioral precautions a lot, particularly when we are in a hurry, we will not be able to properly take those precautions. Then what is left? The only option is a vaccine. So in that scenario, we have to take the vaccine and see to it that the second wave doesn't come. Today, there is a scientific report saying that by April 20th or so, there will be a peak of the second wave, and by which time around 25 lakhs of Indians, around 1/5 or 1/4 of what we had in the first wave, are going to be affected. So in such a scenario, what is the best method I have in my hand? The vaccine. So that is the answer for your why.
So how is it like ensured that it is safe? The COVID vaccine is safe.
Okay, any vaccine to enter into the market and get into the human body, there are several levels of trials called phase one, phase two, phase three. Before the phase one trials, we have animal studies. And all these have been done very successfully by these companies sponsored by international scientific bodies. The companies themselves do not do the research. The scientific bodies have sponsored these companies to do the research and find out the answers by doing the phase two, phase three trials also. And the vaccines that are used in today's world, either in Western world or in India, they have completed phase three trials, and they have been vetted by many internationally reputed people who have all the concerns for the community, have put their brains and hard work into that. And the question of safety doesn't arise at all. If it is not safe, it would not have seen the day of light. It would not have come to the market or to the human body, right?
Yes. With the vaccine, obviously, like because it's according to you, we should all take it. So what could be the side effects that are expected?
Yes.
If you could explain a bit on that so that we are well prepared when we are going for the vaccine.
In fact, the most important part of this particular session is this question. Because each one of us, we are worried about the side effect and not the real effect. Nobody has asked me how good is the vaccine. No, everybody is asking what is the side effect. But here, look at a scenario. I go to the bazaar, take pani puri, and then go and sit in some place and then eat all junk food. I never question whether there are any side effects. And I take all sorts of untoward steps in my life and never question the side effects. But when it comes to the vaccine or a tablet, of course, we all have a concern because this is chemical and this is entering. There are so many other chemicals entering into our body in several ways. But let me just clarify the side effect. Every vaccine, not only this one, will produce what is called the immunogenicity, When the immunogenicity means that is the immunity is developing, there are going to be some mild side effects in the form of a fever, maybe there, low grade fever, 100 fever, 100 degrees like that for 2 or 3 days. And body pains are also quite common. Majority of the patients who have received the vaccine, not patients actually, public who have received the vaccine, they also had, some of them had the body pains, and there will be soreness at the injection site. Where the injection is given, it might become sore and might become hard also. That is possible. Some people might develop little bit of rash or some sort of skin itching sensation. All these are expected not only with the COVID vaccine, for any vaccine for that matter. When the immune response is being triggered, this is how the body shows up that it is working. If somebody develops a few side effects like this, it is good that the body is trying to cope up with the protein that is introduced into the body, and these are of no concern at all, because one, they are not adverse reactions. Adverse reactions are very different. Adverse drug reactions or adverse vaccine reactions are very different, and they're very small in number. These sort of so-called immunogenicity information side effects are around less than 5%. How many people we have vaccinated till date? More than 1.5 crores, sorry, more than 5.5 crores in India are vaccinated. The proportion of people with side effects are very small. So please be rest assured that these are going to resolve in a couple of days, and these side effects are not going to be a problem at all. These are not actually side effects or adverse reactions. Very rarely there could be some vaccine related adverse reactions. That is why we ask the patient to wait for at least 30 minutes in the clinic after the vaccination and to see whether anything develops. Then what do I do? Take simple paracetamol, 650 milligrams of paracetamol, available in the several brands as Dolo or Calpol or something. That subsides, makes the fever and the body pain subside. And there is nothing need to do anything except take liberal quantities of fluid and, if possible, take rest for a couple of days. So these are the most important ways, and never try to use powerful painkillers like diclofenac or anything, because we have seen one or two fatalities when somebody tried to use the diclofenac and other injectables, which are not recommended here. The only thing that is recommended is take good amount of water and rest and take paracetamol. Did I answer your question?
Definitely, Dr. Sharma. So why in that case a vaccine is getting prioritized? Like, why elders and then under the age, above the age of 45, and why is it getting prioritized?
Yeah. You are right. If it is not producing side effects, the vaccine is available, then why not open to everyone? Because everyone is at risk of corona. But then here, the age group, like anybody above 60 years, above 45 with comorbidities, like, you know, other long-standing diseases like diabetes, heart disease, kidney disease, hypertension, and known long-term diseases, these have got, from data we know, these have got a higher risk of developing serious illness, hospitalizable illness, and also the deaths also among these groups. The two important predictors of death are, one is the age, the other is the male gender. Males did not do well in terms of death, and also the people with the diseases which I mentioned. That is why healthcare workers are in the forefront of tackling the pandemic, and that led to what is called the, their exposure is much higher. So that is the reason they are being prioritized, all the healthcare workers and people who are in the other healthcare related, and also people who are in the supply chain, and people who are working hard to keep our lives happy. We are talking about the priority. That is the reason. Healthcare workers are at a higher risk, so they need to be prioritized. And higher senior citizens need to be prioritized. People with diseases, they need to be prioritized, because the number of vaccine doses that are being produced are limited, number of people to be vaccinated are large. So as the production increases, we will be covering, the government will be opening up for more people to take it. And from April 1st onwards, all those above 45 are going to be vaccinated, irrespective of any comorbidity. irrespective of whether they have a disease or not. So April 1st, government is opening up, and very soon they will open it for all the age groups above 18. And government is very seriously considering in those clusters where there are heavy density of the second wave cases, there they wanted to give to everyone, not only to the people above 45. So the strategies keep changing depending on how things develop. So this is as on date, this is the scenario.
So can we get this vaccine in private hospitals as well?
Yeah, because, to start with, government wanted to keep it only in the government institutions. But
no,
there
but
is a lot of
can we get it in medical shops as like available to buy on our own?
Yeah, see, initially government wanted to have it only in the government institutions. But there was a lot of representation from the private hospitals to see that the private hospitals also could take part in the service and deliver the vaccine. So they have said that, you can do it at a very small cost, around 150 rupees towards the vaccination and 100 rupees towards the service charges, which is very nominal compared to the benefit that we get it. It is available, and Government of India has listed it with so many private hospitals in each area. And again, this is not randomly anybody, any private hospital can do it. They have those who have got the approval from the government. They come on the COVIN app, and this is all monitored through your ID card, like Aadhaar card or PAN card, and the vaccine status and your information and the date of vaccination and doses, everything is tagged to your Aadhaar, and you can produce a certificate also from that. So now private institutions are able to give, most of them, senior hospitals, big hospitals, and in a course of time, when the general public is being offered, then more private hospitals are going to be opened up for this.
Over to you, Dr. Kailas.
Yeah, thank you, Surya.
Remember one thing, all of us should need to remember, COVID vaccine is liquid gold. What is it? COVID liquid vaccine gold. Is liquid gold. Will you snatch gold or not?
Obviously.
All of us yes. would like to have gold. This is a liquid gold getting into your body and giving you umpteen and innumerable ways it will help you, I'll tell you.
Yes.
Because definitely. Once we get corona, we know what will happen.
I hope not.
So, okay. We are running out of time, sir, so we will rush up already half an hour over. Okay. Next, I'll ask the next panelist, S.V. Ramanamurthy, to come in. Ramanamurthy is retired Deputy General Manager of Indian Overseas Bank. He used 40 years of his service in bank, worked in different assignments, and has good exposure in all areas of banking. Post-retirement, he utilizes his time in spiritual pursuits and gets all... he is the district president of Sri Satya Sai Seva Organization India and is a co-learner in group Adityana Bharati Shiva Parivarnam, founded and fostered by Dr. Sharma, with the sole aim to highlight Advaita philosophy of Jagat Guru Adi Shankaracharya and the Upanishad. Over to you, Ramanamurthy. We'll finish off your questions, whatever questions you have to Dr. Sharma.
Thank you, Dr. Kailas, yes. for introducing me. I have a great pleasure in being a panelist today. Thank you, Dr. Sharma, for giving the clarification for what Mrs. Sourya Nair has asked. Now that you said vaccine is a liquid gold, we should take it. I really appreciate the warning. So my first question is, what are the two types of vaccines available by Government of India and how do they differ?
Okay, in the whole world, we have 5 vaccines accepted, out of which government of India has rightly picked up 2 vaccines. One is called the Covishield, COVI shield, Covishield. The other is called the Covaxin. There's a slight difference in the technology in which they are manufactured. Covishield is a adenoviral vector non-replicating vaccine. Technically speaking, if you buy, that is the name, but if you buy a diamond ring, let us say, you buy a diamond ring, what you do is they will keep it in a box and give you, and once you come home, you rip open the box and keep the diamond ring. The viral protein is kept in a ring-like thing of an adenoviral vector, which is not an active virus, which is a dead, killed virus, into that it is kept and then given into the body. Why? For it to reach the site where it has to work, the viral protein need to be protected by a covering. that covering is there around that, and that will be opened up, and the virus, the protein will be useful for generation of the immunity. That is Covishield by the what Serum Institute of India, Pune, and along with the research molecule of the AstraZeneca internationally around AstraZeneca. Needless to say that SIIR, Serum Institute of India, is one of the major vaccine producing agencies in the world. The second one is by the Bharat Biotech, which is equally renowned, and both these vaccines are being made in India vaccines, and they don't require very minus temperatures like the vaccines being used in the Western world. So our country is a tropical country, and the government of India and scientific community has rightly decided that these vaccines, which don't require very deep cooling temperatures, are chosen. And the second vaccine, Covishield, is an inactivated vaccine. Rather, it is a killed viral vaccine. The virus is taken, coronavirus as such, and it is inactivated and killed and used. It is not some small protein of the vaccine. The whole virus is used, but it is inactivated and killed so that it doesn't produce disease in the human body once it is injected. So one is a small protein of the virus is taken and put it in an adenoviral shell and given. The other is a simple virus which is destroyed and given. Both have very good immunogenicity. Both are equally good. There is nothing to choose between them. You can take either one of them because both have completed the phase 3 trials. The immunogenicity is similar to both. When I say similar, scientifically, 85 is not different from 87. You may read in paper, one is giving 85, another is 87. I will go for, no, that's not like that. 85 or 87 or 83 and 85 are scientifically no different. So both of them are equally good. Only thing is, instead of asking the question, which I have to take, better ask, I require to take. Please give me. So that will be my response for that.
Thank you, doctor. You have, what was drained in my mind that which I should take? You have clarified it. But there is no difference, as you say. Anyone, we can take it. That's what from my layman's understanding, both are equally good. And we can opt anyone, whatever comes into the
correct.
Thank you. So I got another question to ask you. What is then, anyone will take it, but what is the recommended dose and schedule?
Yeah, there is a slight difference here. So here, the recommended dose is Covishield, AstraZeneca vaccine, Covishield, adenoviral vector non-replicating vaccine, the box I told you, know that one has to be taken at an interval of 6 to 8 weeks. Earlier it was 4 weeks. Now recently, 4 days back, Government of India and scientific community have decided to make it 6 to 8 weeks. They take the first dose, from then onwards 6 weeks to 8 weeks is the duration for the second dose for Covishield. If you are taking the inactivated viral vaccine, Covaxin by Bharat Biotech, the distance is 4 weeks only.
What is the next question, sir? Till he comes.
What if I take only one dose? I don't go for the second dose.
So please understand, one dose is not enough because you'll get only 30 to 40% immunity in the first dose. But the subsequent doses will give you a booster effect and give you about 80 to 90% immunity. So one dose is not enough. One dose pota poradu. Rendavathu dose compulsory vano.
So that is a must. Second dose is a must.
It's a must. It's a must.
Okay. Okay. And the suppose I forget to take the second dose, then after some time, am I to take again the first dose and the second dose like that? Anything is there?
No.
Within the period, I couldn't take the second dose. After a period of two or three months.
It doesn't matter, even if you forget, the first dose immunity will last for some time. So if you take the second dose, then it gives a booster effect and gives you the... But don't forget to take the second dose. Even if you miss the date of 1 month or 2 months, take it after some time so that you cannot accidentally forget, because people, you will be bombarded with the SMS for taking the second dose. So marakave maraka matenga. Marinda kuda, please take it after some time. That is what is important.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I got disconnected. Let us continue.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. The minimal, Dr. Kailash clarified some of the answers.
Very good. Very good. To bridge the time.
I got two questions. I was there. If I forget the what I take, only one dose, or if I don't take second dose, he clarified it.
Very
second,
good.
I said if I forget to take the second dose, if I want to take after some time, whether I'm to again go for first dose, he said not depend with the schedule, you can go for the second dose.
Correct.
So these are my questions. Very nicely clarified, Doctor. Thank you, Dr. Sarma ji, for giving all these clarifications. It's very, very useful for the public at large. A lot of misnomers, a lot of doubts are there. So this session is very useful that way. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Ramanamurthy. Now we'll go to the next panelist, Uma Anuradha. Mrs. Anuradha is a postgraduate in computer science. Currently, she's a homemaker and lives in Hyderabad. She's a mother of two and also taking care of two senior citizens at home. She sees herself as a responsible citizen, contributing to overcoming the challenges of the pandemic in the most responsible and scientific manner. Over to you, Uma, for the questions.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, Sarmagaru. Am I audible?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, now that it is very clear that everyone has to take vaccine, and I came, so many doubts are already clarified, and I came to know that now each vaccine consists of two doses.
Please unmute yourself.
It's unmute. Am I audible?
You are audible, Ms. Anuradha. I'm just, okay. I think Dr. Sharma's, his network is again. Okay. Problematic.
So, both the doses
will answer the questions. We answer, no problem.
Both the doses will have the same strength and content, or do they differ?
Both the strengths are the same. There is no difference in the strength. It's the same. It's only a booster effect. The second dose gives the booster effect. Like any other vaccine, the second DPT triple antigen போடுறோம் இல்லையா சின்ன வயசுல போட்டதுக்கு அப்புறம் the second dose is given first, third month, fourth month, fifth month. It's only to give the booster effect. We take the second dose. It's the same dose. It's the same medicine.
Okay. 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 Thank you, sir.
Dr. Sharma is back.
Yeah, back.
And if a person already has got corona,
please go ahead.
Suppose if a person has already got corona and he is treated, okay. What if he has to take the vaccine or not?
Very good question. In fact, many of the patients do ask, sir, I had corona, should I take it? Yes, you have to, but not when there is active infection. For example, somebody has got corona, we need to wait around 4 weeks time, give a gap of 4 weeks until the last test is positive. Corona positivity will last for about 2 to 3 weeks. So when the last test is positive, then the last test is negative, that means he has become corona negative. From that time onwards, you wait for a 4 week period before we really give corona vaccine. And in fact, they are not the priority group because they already have protection naturally by the infection. Nonetheless, they have to have the vaccine 4 weeks after the last test being negative.
And what if the person has undergone a plasma treatment during the COVID treatment?
Very good question. Plasma treatment is we give antibodies to fight the coronavirus. Okay. We give a solution of antibodies in the to fight the coronavirus. This virus also tries to generate similar antibodies. So those antibodies will interfere with the viral protein and will not allow the antibodies to come nicely in the body. So with the result, we don't recommend giving COVID vaccine for those who had plasma treatment for at least 4 weeks. Okay, after the plasma treatment, by then what will happen, whatever plasma has been injected, it gets in sort of metabolized and then used up in the body, and it is no more available. At that time you can give, not immediately after the plasma therapy, for the simple reason that the immunity development will be very poor if you give immediately. Nothing will happen, but immunity will not develop. Okay.
And other question is, do I need to check on my antibodies to confirm my immunity?
Very common question. Most of my patients do ask, and many of these agencies, labs and all, they say, no, did you have corona vaccine? I'll check and tell you whether it is working or not. No. Don't depend on that. There is no international or national recommendation to do an antibody test after the viral vaccine. In fact, we don't do it for any disease. For example, we give polio vaccine, are we monitoring the antibodies? We give hepatitis, are we monitoring the antibodies? No, it is not a general practice to monitor the antibodies, and don't do that for two reasons. One, antibodies may not be able to tell you right the protection that is offered. Antibody is only an immune response, but protection is offered by, there is another type of immunity called the T cell immunity. There are two types of immunities. One is called the B cell immunity, which is measured by the antibody. There is a T cell immunity, which is also elicited by the virus as well as the vaccine, and that is not measurable by the antibody test. And the long lasting one is the T cell immunity. Okay, the antibodies only tell me what is the level at that point, but there is what is called the memory antibodies in the system. These are called the memory cells. These memory cells are not tested, neither the T cells. That is why antibody monitoring is not recommended. Don't fall prey. Somebody asking to give me 500 rupees, I'll test the antibodies. Please don't do that.
Thank you, Anuradha. Do you have
I have one more question, sir. As a responsible neighbor, I am asking this question. One of my neighbor is carrying and other is feeding her baby. Do they need to take vaccine or?
Pregnant woman not advised, breastfeeding woman advised, lactating woman advised, because we know that the vaccine, once it is given to the breastfeeding mother, it is going to the baby too, okay, through the milk. There is no hurdle for giving breastfeeding after the vaccination, but pregnant women, the trials are not there, so we hope that it will work in pregnant women also. These are not live viruses either. They are not going to cause harm to the pregnant women. But unless we have scientific evidence that they are safe, we are not recommended.
I think, yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Anuradha, have you finished your questions?
Thank you, Dr. Samagaru.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, Kailash, sir. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for giving the opportunity.
I think there are a lot of audience and who can understand Tamil also, Sharmaji. Maybe we can, Tamil kuda we can answer some of the questions.
But definitely, sir. Certain sella questions Tamil la answer pandrathukku try pannalam. Thappum illa.
Very, very important. Particularly this antibody testing, paathirukkeengla, a lot of companies are coming. In fact, a couple of labs came to me, vandha engalukku vandha neenga the antibody test panninga. I also foolishly did the test. but now I understand adu prayojanam illa abdingar theriyudhu naan nadichirund I was asking wanting everybody and the test panikalamana it's not necessary
edunala prayojanam illa andradhu vande one vandu antibody titer does not reflect protection rendavathu vandu ind antibody memory antibody test pannadhu moonavathu vandu id T cell immunity test pannadhu அப்ப என்ன என்னத்துக்கு இது டெம்பரரியா அந்த நேரத்துக்கு இருக்கிற IgG IgM பிக் அப் பண்ணும் அது ஒண்ணுமே பிரயோஜனம் இருக்காது
எக்ஸாக்ட்லி அதனால ஓகே வெரி குட் சோ வீல் கோ ஆன் டு தி நெக்ஸ்ட் பேனலிஸ்ட் மிஸ்டர் கே ரவிக்குமார் இஸ் a போஸ்ட் கிராஜுவேட் இன் இன்ஜினியரிங் அண்ட் மேனேஜ்மென்ட் ஃப்ரம் ISB ஹைதராபாத் ஹி வொர்க்ஸ் ஆஸ் an IT அண்ட் மேனேஜ்மென்ட் சீனியர் கன்சல்டன்ட் ஹைதராபாத் மோட்டிவேட்டட் டு கான்ட்ரிபியூட் ஃபார் தி வெல்ஃபேர் ஆஃப் ஆல் ஓடியோ கே ரவிக்குமார்
தேங்க் யூ டாக்டர் கைலாஷ் ஐ ஹேவ் a few questions to டாக்டர் ஷர்மா
வெல்கம்
Sir, firstly, after how many days of getting the vaccine would a person develop a protection?
This is true for any vaccine. Supposing I take polio drops, I give polio drops to the child. It takes time for the immunity to develop. Here also, generally for all the vaccines, we require a primary dose followed by a second dose. And here also we have two doses. Some vaccines have only one dose, some have three doses, and this has two doses. In the two doses, at the end of the second dose, 10 days later, the full protection develops. It doesn't mean that after first dose, there won't be any antibodies. There will be antibodies to the tune of 60% to 70%, 80%, but they are further augmented by the second dose, and the full protection is available from 10 days after the second dose. Whichever is the second dose, maybe 6 weeks to 8 weeks for COVID shield or 4 weeks for Covaxin.
Thank you, sir. And a follow-up question is, how long will this vaccine provide immunity to a person?
That is a very important question. Because if I take the vaccine and if it gives me lifelong protection, it will be wonderful. For example, pneumococcal disease, there is a bacterial disease called the pneumococci. This pneumococcal vaccine, once in a lifetime, it is enough. You don't have to take again. Whereas this one, the viral vaccines, usually every year they keep on coming with a new blazer, and then the quotes keep changing and we have to give. For example, influenza vaccine or H1N1, you would have heard, that vaccine has to be given every year. So we expect that this vaccine also might be required to be given every year if we are having COVID virus around. The other thing is, none of the people who are studied have completed more than 6 months from their last sort of dose, which means we know the information that it is protective up to a maximum of 6 months as of now. Supposing you ask me the same question at the end of the year, then I will say, okay, based on the experience, we know it could protect probably for 1 year. So at the moment, we have data up to 6 months. We are hoping that it will at least protect for 1 year. And we may require a booster dose at the end of 1 year if we are still having COVID around.
Thank you, sir. And see, for the last 12 months, we've all been, you know, restricted to our house. Our mobility has been severely curtailed. So does that mean that, you know, I can roam around without a mask once I get vaccinated?
Absolutely not. The emphatic no. Vaccine is only protective for hospitalizations, for deaths, and for severe illness. So what is it protecting? No matter what vaccine we are giving, whether we are giving COVID shield or Covaxin or the two Western countries vaccine, all of them uniformly demonstrated no deaths in the vaccinated group. That is the greatest boon. One doesn't die. Second thing is they won't go on to the tube and severe illness. That is the greatest boon. The third thing is people might still experience mild COVID in spite of the vaccine, some of them. So in that case, what happens? If you don't protect yourself with the mask, you might get the cold, milder illness. So, and another thing is, there is another type of illness called the asymptomatic illness. That means person will not have any symptoms, but will have the virus. Whatever he will do, he or she will give it to the other person. So transmissibility is there. For that reason of transmissibility, for that reason of chances of contracting the disease, though milder in nature, we require to protect ourselves with the mask, social distancing, and hand sanitization, 6 feet distance. They will continue to be there whether we are vaccinated or unvaccinated.
Next question is the vaccine really mandatory? I mean, what if a person doesn't want to take the vaccine?
This is a democratic country. So we can't force, like, you know, communist countries that everybody has to be vaccinated, and by force we can't give it. So for example, when the corona came in China, everybody on the road, they put the CT scanners and made people go through the CT scanners as a sort of rule. We can't do that. But all the same, legal responsibility is different from moral responsibility. We all have moral responsibility. We have civic responsibility. We have to behave as civilized people and people who have concern for not only ourselves, for others. For that reason, even if it is not mandatory, in our mind, we should think it is mandatory. It is not mandatory by law. Nobody is going to arrest you or put you behind bars or fine you for that. But we have to think it is mandatory. In the mind, it is mandatory. In the bhavana, it is mandatory to me.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. And final question. Now that you're sort of convinced on the importance of taking the virus, you know, what is this COVID about, and how does one register?
See,
and what kind of a certificate is obtained?
I wonder whether any other country has got any single window system, a sort of digitalized platform for COVID vaccine in other countries. We, Government of India, has brought out a beautiful COWIN app, COWIN, COWIN app, wherein you register, you identify your center, you find out your date, and you know your next dose, and you report your side effects. Everything is monitored and tagged to your ID card, Aadhaar card, or PAN card. And this will also generate a certificate at the end of both the doses, which is internationally valid certificate of COVID vaccination. So I don't know any other country has really got a population of 130 plus crores to just generate an app like this and work. It is really amazing on the IT section of the Government of India doing it. All of you, please register in the Cowin app and schedule your appointment. You will know how beautiful it is.
Sure, Dr. Sharma, thanks for answering my questions. Thank you, Dr. Kailash, for the opportunity.
Okay. Mr. Ravi, actually, you said whether it's mandatory, but please understand we are trying such programs only to get into the mind of every person. Pannikongada, and the vaccine pannikong, adukkada kashtapadrom. We are trying. All doctors are trying our best to influence people. Pannikonga, vaccine podukonga. This program is only to impress. Even if the 100 audience who have come here go for vaccine, we are happy.
Correct.
Okay.
So we must spread the message to others.
Yes.
These 100 audience should spread the message. It is not legally mandatory, but it is imperative in your brain. You have to protect yourself and protect others.
In fact, every attendee here should see to it. You see another 10 of you are vaccinated.
Correct.
Not only protects you, it protects us also, because indirectly we will not get the disease. Fine.
Correct.
We had panelists from the public to ask Dr. Sharma. Now we will bring in some doctors to ask Dr. Sharma. Now I request Dr. Girija Ramamurthy. She's presently secretary of IMA Chennai Metro. She's an excellent physician with more than 38 years of experience in hospital and clinical setting. She's worked as an emergency physician in a multi-specialty hospital in Chennai for the last 18 years. Currently, she's doing online consultation for patients. She's very active in conducting CMA programs, and she helps me in conducting all these doctor public society meeting and the senior citizen meeting. Over to you, Dr. Girija.
Thank you, Dr. Kailash, for your kind introduction. I would like to ask a few questions to Dr. Sharma. These are the questions enoda patients engitta kekkra questions. On behalf of the public, I'm going to ask. First question is, many of them are asking whether a vaccinated person, he or she, can get infected with COVID-19 again.
Very good question. This is very important. As I told you, no vaccine is 100% protective. No vaccine on the globe, including all the vaccines which we are using against measles, polio, typhoid, whatever disease you say, no vaccine is 100% protective. Having said that, the immunogenicity is in a protection on the romba adhikama irukudhu. Adhanaala vandhi yaravadhu vandhi oru vela COVID infection contract pandra the infected patient oda contract irundha COVID vaccination potukna kuda thirumbi COVID infection varadhukku vaayippu irukku illenu solla mudiyadhu. எவ்வளவு அளவுக்கு ஒரு 10%? நார்மலா 100% இருந்ததுன்னா ஒரு கான்டாக்ட்னால இங்க ஒரு 10% 15% சான்ஸ் திருப்பி இவங்களை கூட இன்ஃபெக்ட் ஆகிறதுக்கு வாய்ப்பு இருக்கு. பர்டிகுலர்லி இஃப் தே ஹவ் நாட் கம்ப்ளீட்டட் போத் த டோசஸ் இமீடியட்லி ஆஃப்டர் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டோஸ் சட்டன்லி தேர் வல்னரபிள். ஆஃப்டர் கொஞ்ச நாள் ஆச்சுன்னா ஒரு 15 நாளைக்கு கொஞ்சம் ஆன்டிபாடிஸ் வரும். 1.5 மாசம் ஆச்சு ரெண்டாவது டோஸ் போட்டாங்கன்னா கொஞ்சம் நல்லா ப்ரொடக்டிவா இருக்கும். அப்போ போட்டுக்கணும் பிரயோஜனம் இல்லையா? கண்டிப்பாக பிரயோஜனம் இருக்கு. என்ன பிரயோஜனமும் இதனால யாருக்கும் டெர்த்து வரப்போகிறது இல்லை. ரெண்டாவது இதனால வந்து யாருக்கும் சீரியஸ் டிசீஸ் வராது, ஹாஸ்பிட்டலில் அட்மிட் ஆக வேண்டிய அவசியம் வராது. வந்தால் கூட ஒரு மைல்டு கோல்டு மாதிரி வந்து போகும். இதனால என்ன ஆகும்? எனக்கு வரும், மைல்டாக இருக்கும், அதனால ஹாஸ்பிட்டல் போக மாட்டேன், வீட்டில் இருந்து எல்லாருக்கும் டிரான்ஸ்மிட் பண்ண போகிறேன். அப்போ என்ன பண்ணணும்? நான் மாஸ்க் சானிடைசேஷன் எல்லாம் போட்டிருந்தேன். மொமெண்ட் பாசிட்டிவ் வந்தேன்னா மறுபடியும் எல்லா ப்ரிகாஷன்ஸும் எடுத்துகிட்டு அந்த குவாரண்டைன் ப்ரிகாஷன்ஸோடு அந்த 14 நாள் ஒரு மாதிரி ஹவுஸ் அரெஸ்ட் மாதிரி பண்ணிக்கின்னு எதுவும் பிரச்சனை இல்லாமல் பார்த்துக்கணும். ஸோ அதனால் வராதனே இல்லை, வரும், ஆனால் ரொம்ப மைல்டாக தான் வரும் அது.
Thank you, sir. I would like to cite an example here. Ennoda oru distant relative, he had his first dose of COVID vaccine and hardly within five days he developed symptoms and he was found to be positive. He was hospitalized and he died a week later.
That is unfortunate. Because the duration of he would have already had the COVID virus in the body at the time vaccine was given, and it is 4-5 days incubation period where it might be there. So yes. It is unfortunate that he had the vaccine, but he had the virus or just had the virus after the vaccine. And the vaccine doesn't protect until 10 days after the second dose.
So, thank you, sir. My second question is, who all should be excluded from vaccination?
Yeah, if we look at the international literature, there are no specific contraindications. அப்படியா இவங்களுக்கு கொடுக்க கூடாது என்ற லிஸ்ட் எதுமே இல்ல. சில வேக்சின்ஸ்க்கு அந்த மாதிரி இருக்கும், இதுக்கு அந்த மாதிரி எதுவுமே இல்லை. இருந்தாலும் ஒவ்வொரு வேக்சின்ல ரகரக்கமான கெமிக்கல்ஸ் இருக்கும். தோஸ் கெமிக்கல்ஸ் இஃப் சம்படி இஸ் அலர்ஜிக் ஆர் ஹேவிங் அனஃபிளாக்சிஸ் டு தோஸ் கெமிக்கல்ஸ் தே மைட் கெட் சம் சீரியஸ் ரியாக்ஷன். How do I know that? அவன் என்ன பண்ணணும், பீப்புள் ஹூ ஹாவ் அலர்ஜிக் ரியாக்ஷன்ஸ், பீப்புள் ஹூ ஆர் ஆல்ரெடி நோன் அனாஃபிலாக்டிக் பேஷண்ட்ஸ், தே ஹேவ் டு இன்ஃபார்ம் த ஹெல்த் கேர் ஒர்க்கர்ஸ். அவங்களுக்கு சொல்லிட்டு இந்த மாதிரி எனக்கு ஒரு ஹிஸ்ட்ரி இருக்கையா, இந்த விதமாக எனக்கு அலர்ஜி இருக்குதுன்னா, தே வில் டேக் ஆல் த கேர் அண்ட் சி தட் தே டூ நாட் லேண்ட் அப் இன் சீரியஸ் அலர்ஜிக் ரியாக்ஷன். அதனால வந்து எதுவும் ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் கான்ட்ராஇண்டிகேஷன் இல்லை, தெரிஞ்சு எதனா அலர்ஜி இருக்குதுன்னா கண்டிப்பாக உங்கள் டாக்டருக்கும் ஹெல்த் கேர் ஒர்க்கருக்கும் பேஷண்ட் ரிப்போர்ட் பண்ணணும். அவங்களுக்கு கூட ஒரு ஃபார்ம் கொடுப்பாங்க, அந்த ஃபார்மில் டூ ஹேவ் எனி அலர்ஜிஸ்னா அது கரெக்டாக டிக் பண்ணணும், நோ நோன்னு டிக் பண்ணி போகக்கூடாது, ஏதோ இன்கம் டேக்ஸ் ஃபார்ம் டிக் பண்ண மாதிரி. ஓகே.
So my next question is, there are many people with immunosuppressants and immunocompromised people, patients with SLE, renal transplant, organ transplant patients and all. Can it be given to them?
Now the point is, if you are using a live attenuated vaccines, then immunocompromised, immunosuppressed and people on corticosteroids, இவங்களுக்கு எல்லாம் கொடுக்கக்கூடாது. நம்ம லைவ் அட்டென்டட் வேக்சின் யூஸ் பண்ணுறது இல்லையே, நம்ம வந்து கில்டு வேக்சின் வரும் ஒன்று, ரெண்டாவது வந்து வைரல் வெக்டர் வேக்சின். இந்த ரெண்டுமே கூட இம்யூனோ காம்ப்ரமைஸ் பேஷண்ட்ஸ்க்கு ரொம்ப சேஃப்னு சொல்லணும். இந்த ரெண்டும் எதுக்கு ப்ரிஃபர் பண்ணாங்கன்னா கவர்மெண்ட்டு, இம்யூனோ காம்ப்ரமைஸ்டு பீப்புள், ஹெச்ஐவி இருக்கிறவங்க, இல்லைன்னா வேறு எது விதமாக ட்ரக்ஸ்னால இம்யூனோ காம்ப்ரமைஸ்டாக இருக்கிறாங்கன்னா கூட, அவங்களுக்கு கூட எதுவுமே ப்ராப்ளம் இல்லாமல் இருக்கிறதுக்கு தான் இந்த எடினா வைரல் வேக்சினும், இல்லைன்னா இந்த கம்ப்ளீட் கீல்டு வேக்சின் தான் யூஸ் பண்ணுறாங்க. லைவ் அட்டன்வேட்டட் வேக்சின்ஸும் யூஸ் பண்ணக்கூடாது. அது எப்படியும் கவர்மெண்ட் சூஸ் பண்ணுறது இல்லை, அது நம்ம எடுக்கவும் இல்லை, ஒன்றும் பிரச்சனை இருக்காது.
So some common question is, எனக்கு வந்து skin allergy இருக்கு, medicine allergy இருக்கு, இல்ல எது சாப்பிட்ட allergy இருக்கு, in the patients whether we can go for the vaccine or not.
For example, certain vaccines, for example, you have a rabies vaccine. நாய் கடிச்சதுன்னா vaccine போடுவாங்க இல்லையா, rabies vaccine. அந்த vaccine வந்து egg proteinோட தயாராகும். சிக் எம்ப்ரியோ டக் எம்ப்ரியோலோ அது வந்து ஹார்வெஸ்ட் பண்ணுவாங்க. அந்த மாதிரி சிச்சுவேஷன் இங்கே கிடையாது. இந்த ரெண்டு வேக்சின்ஸும் கூட போத் ஆஃப் தெம் டூ நாட் ஹாவ் எனி காம்பனண்ட் ரிலேட்டட் டு சிக் ஆர் டக் ஆர் எனி எக். ஸோ எக் ப்ரோட்டீன் அலர்ஜி இஸ் நாட் எ கான்ட்ராஇண்டிகேஷன். பட் இஃப் எ பர்சன் ஹேஸ் காட் எ ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் நோன் அலர்ஜி டு எனி ஃபுட் ஆர் எனி ட்ரக் ஆர் எனி எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் ப்ரீவியஸ்லி, தே ஆர் நாட் லைக் ஜென்ரல் பப்ளிக். They have to inform the healthcare worker and they will assess and see whether they can be done, and if necessary they even keep them for half a day completely after the vaccine and then send them home. This is the precaution they have to take, but egg wise there is no problem.
Thank you, sir. Somebody in the chat box is asking to talk us in English.
I will keep English as well as Tamil, both will be my medium of conversation. Mostly it will be English, no problem.
Another question is, what age of children can be vaccinated, and if so, what is the dose?
So there are 4 or 5 vaccines which are approved internationally. 2 in India we are using. Unfortunately, children are not the priority segment because the disease is very mild in them. The disease rate is also very low, and that is why no trial has included children in the initial trials. But now, the Pfizer has started a trial in children. Other companies, Moderna is starting. Other COVID Shield Covaxin also children's trials will start very soon. Once that information is available, they will be definitely vaccinated. Children also, but they are on a low priority. 2 reasons. 1, they don't contract COVID. This is not a childhood disease. Second thing is their mortality is 0 almost in children less than 5 years. For those reasons, children are not prioritized in this. Once the trial data is there, it will be extended to children below 18 years also.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Over to Dr. Kailash to introduce the next panelist. I think you are the next panelist.
Yeah. Okay. I will start off. We have almost completed an hour. We'll finish off in another 5-10 minutes. Dr. Sharma, I gave a talk on this vaccination recently. There is Covishield, an adenovirus, another virus is taken, and the spike protein is put into another virus. Immediately one person asks, see, what will happen if another virus is injected into the body? Already I'm scared of coronavirus. Another virus being injected into the body. So what do I do for this? Maybe you can explain this to the audience.
So that virus is not there.
Am I audible?
Yeah. Please.
Put your question, sir.
Sir, they say In Covishield, an adenovirus is taken and the spike protein is introduced into the adenovirus and given to you.
Okay.
Let
me just share that. Let me just share my screen so that you will be able to see what is that. Okay.
Yeah.
So I'll share the screen. In the meantime, I'm explaining you that the what exactly is meant by that adenovirus and this one. COVID panel. Can you see my screen? I am sharing it.
No, I can't see that. But anyway.
You will be able to see very soon. I am going to. Can you see my screen now?
No, you just started. Yes, this is dashboard.
Yes, we can.
Dashboard.
You can see the screen, right?
Yeah.
Now, you see here.
Yes.
This is the viral vector. What you are talking about is this AstraZeneca vaccine, viral vector vaccine.
Exactly.
What we are taking, the adenovirus, a harmless viral vector carrying the coronavirus. This is the coronavirus. Yes. The upper one is the coronavirus. Okay. And from that coronavirus, we have taken a little protein which is going to be useful for immunogenicity. That we have put it in another capsule. This capsule is a inactivated virus, adenovirus. This adenovirus is a chimpanzee virus. This has got nothing to do with human infection. And this is there in the chimpanzees as a commensal virus. And it is not even a very dangerous virus even in the chimpanzees. Why that is used? That is used to take the protein into the body and deliver the protein to the site where the immunogenicity will start. There are what are called the antigen presenting cells. And to go there, there should be a cover, just like you bring a diamond ring with a cover and the cover is stripped off and thrown in the dustbin and only the protein part of it, the virus, is used to generate the immunogenicity. So though it is called adenoviral vector, it is not a virus, number one, in the sense it is killed and it is also only the coat of it is taken and the core of the virus is removed and it is completely safe and it is neither pathogenic to human beings.
Yeah.
That is the adenoviral vector. Be rest assured that no other virus is being introduced into the body.
Excellent.
So you see, this is the virus. This is what we are doing as the dead coronavirus. This is the inactivated or killed virus, wherein we take the coronavirus as it is, and then all the proteins of the coronavirus are put in the body, but only they are killed. That is the difference. It is not a live attenuated vaccine. It is a killed vaccine. Both the vaccines are very safe. Okay.
Good. In fact, this is one. Another thing is, a lot of people indicate that see lot of mutated virus like the British virus, which is called mutated. If in the virus protocol, the mutated virus or a vaccine rather than a better. Why should you have the mutated virus vaccine?
Yeah.
Is it necessary to wait for that?
Okay, viruses, unlike bacteria, are notorious to change their outer covering. What is mutation? Change in the outer covering proteins of the virus. The inner core remains the same only. The outer covering proteins will change so that it can adapt and produce more infection. These mutations are notorious to happen with many viruses and including the influenza virus. That is why every year a new batch of influenza virus vaccine is released. If you read the packet, it will say Influax 2021. That means it is tailored for the virus of that year. So like that, here also mutations do occur. And the present vaccines which we are using in the world, the two we are using as well as the other, are very effective against the most of the variants, except one or two, which Lancet has recently published, that they did not get enough antibody protection for those mutants. So we can't wait for all the mutations to happen and then only prepare a vaccine against all and give it. At some point, we have to start giving it. Otherwise, we are dying with the disease. So it nonetheless, having said that, this vaccine works for most of the variants or mutants known, excepting a few, two or three, and the viral vaccine will be re-engineered if those mutations are significantly present in the community.
Yeah, even Lancet published a paper saying that the Covaxin has got the highest protection. In fact, I was so happy that Bharat Biotech is producing Covaxin, and that gives the highest immunity against mutants. Is it a fact?
Between the two, Covaxin is slightly scoring over the immunogenicity in terms. I told you, antibody response is not the true picture of the immunogenicity because we don't know about the T cells, we don't know about the memory B cells. But the level of protection offered by Covaxin is around 3 to 4 points higher. If one is 80, the other is 84. Scientifically, they are not different. But regarding mutation, both the Covaxin and
Covishield, both give the protection. Good. So the next question which everybody is, we have the patient says, sir, enna maatra nirthala sir, vaccine podathukku munale I'm taking anticoagulants, clopidogrel.
We are dealing with new disease.
Yeah. Dr. Sharma, are you there? Or Dr. Sharma, are you there? Yes.
Yeah, now, yeah.
Another thing which everybody asks is, as a doctor, no, they'll say, I'm taking these tablets, I'm taking clopidogrel, I'm taking aspirin. Do I have to stop this before taking the vaccine?
And one important.
Every doctor.
One, am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, audible.
Okay. Now, diabetics, hypertensives, heart patients have to take COVID vaccine because they come under the high morbidity. Regarding the drugs that they are taking, these generally they call blood thinners, the word introduced by the Western country. We never use the word blood thinner here. Now, there are what are called the antiplatelet agents, which are given as a protection for heart patients, diabetics, and others. This is aspirin and clopidogrel. There is no need to stop, underline, no need to stop aspirin and clopidogrel for giving COVID vaccine. But there will be a small section of heart patients who will be taking what are called the anticoagulants. What are they? Like heparin, low molecular weight heparin, dabigatran, and things like that, which are anticoagulants, which will prevent the blood to clot actually. Antiplatelets are which make the platelets very soft and sort of docile and don't harm the body. They don't have to be stopped. But if somebody is on anticoagulants, a week of stopping those drugs will be required when COVID vaccination is taken. But the doctor who is taking care of the patient should be informed if they are taking anticoagulants. They are taking antiplatelets, no need to stop.
Sir, what I heard from a cardiologist is if the INR is above 3, they should not take.
If it is between 2 and 3, they can. INR will be high when you use only heparin, when you use low molecular weight, not when you use platelet agents. Platelet agents will never increase the INR. INR is a measure of the non-coagulability of blood. That is a function of the drugs like dabigatran, low molecular heparin, conventional heparin, things like that. So people who are taking anticoagulants, then you do the INR. If the INR is very much within normal limits, the cardiologist might allow to continue the drug and the vaccine. If the INR is slightly more, they will stop the anticoagulant and then give the vaccine again, come back with the anticoagulant. Or they reduce the dose, but not with antiplatelet agents. Okay.
Sir, where is Dr. Kailash?
I don't know. He might have got disconnected.
He's not in the call right now.
He's also getting disconnected now and again. Now you continue the questions, madam, on behalf of
two,
you.
So two questions in the chat box.
Yeah.
One is whether patients with the bleeding diathesis, whether they can go for this injection.
No.
Bleeding diathesis.
People who have bleeding diathesis, who have bleeding disorders, people who are anticoagulants, they must be observed in the hospital and the risk-benefit ratio will be weighed by the treating physician, hematologist, then only be given. Somebody is a hemophilia patient. Somebody is a patient of Christmas disease. Somebody is having severe bleeding diathesis. And this is not a like general public. And how many will be there out of the 130 crores? Very small proportion. And that has to be individually dealt and not on a general routine recommendation for them.
Sir, another question in the chat box is, there are many people who have taken the two doses now at the Covishield at 4 weeks apart. So what they have to do now? Because
now the question, after 6 to 8 weeks. Now I understand their concern. They have taken exactly 4 weeks the second dose. Now yes. Government of India said no, not 4 weeks. Go to yes. 6 to 8 weeks. Should you take another dose? Not required. Yes. See, why the point is, if you take it 4 weeks, if the antibody response is, let us say, 82%, if you take it 6 weeks, it is 85%. If you take it 8 weeks, probably it is 87%. Only the degree is slightly better. That is why they are offering the 6 to 8 weeks. Nothing will happen. For example, I have taken 4 weeks apart, two doses. I don't require to take another dose. This is good enough protection already. And here, the pass mark is 70% and above. A vaccine giving a protection of 70% has already passed. There is no question of being further past, a past man becoming further past. Okay, and it is not like mathematics marks. Nobody can get 100%, and there is no difference between 85, 87, 82, 83. Okay.
Sir, other questions in the chat box, I think you are already answered. I have got a question, sir. Why vaccination is especially an important strategy against COVID?
Again, this was brought out by Surya to start with. I asked you, I mean, it's good that you also have brought this question again. Look here, there are 4 or 5 strong reasons. One, this is a new disease. We do not know much about it in treatment, in terms of protection, in terms of transmission and all. It is a very severely transmissible disease.
I think
it is not like cold. It is going to give you fatality, and the mask, social distancing, sanitization and all are not going to really be very methodically and also scrupulously followed by everyone. I am left with only one option, that is the vaccine. If I take two doses, the body will take care. I don't have to really worry, but all the same, continue my preventive measures. That is the reason vaccine takes a higher priority, particularly in the scenario of second wave. How do I prevent my second wave? By taking vaccine. Other countries which saw the second wave, like Europe and other countries, they don't have the vaccine when the second wave started. We are in the greatest advantage. Our second wave is coming very late. By now, we are already having the vaccine in hand. So let us use to the best advantage the vaccine.
Other few questions.
There's a question in Q&A.
Dust allergy patients, other eosinophilia patients, whether they can go for the vaccine.
No problem, they can go. Simple eosinophilia, simple dust allergy doesn't prevent one from taking vaccine. They can go. All the precaution is they take some anti-allergic, during that period so that they don't suffer more, right?
Another question is, what has helped in India have a relatively less number of deaths and infected compared to some other countries?
Yeah, this is not related to COVID vaccine, but we will answer it. Because India, we have a population of around 130 crores. Out of that, our total case load is around 101.6 crores plus as on date. And then the mortality is around 1.3%. Some Western countries have recorded a mortality of 10, 11, 12%. The reasons are those countries, the aging population is more. Our population is comparatively young. Their people 80 plus are much more, and they are the ones who succumbed. Second thing is their immunity levels for general infections is much lower because of a relatively sterile environment there. Here we are living in infection, we are breathing infection, and then we are through with the infection. So we somehow have probably a sort of innate immunity to protect ourselves. And there is a hypothesis that BCG, India is BCG vaccinated, and BCG might be offering some protection.
Another question is, can we take a Covaxin, one dose Covaxin and the next dose
no.
Vice versa?
If you take one Covaxin, take Covaxin. If you take Covishield, because the way in which they are engineered are different, the immunogenicity response is different. They will not work well if you combine one with the other. You have to take...
All other questions are answered by you, sir, already. And please give us a quick overview of the current status of COVID and vaccination in India.
Now, are there any questions in the chat box? Anybody can see? Surya,
asking questions already answered, sir.
Okay. Okay.
What will be
the chances? So, common question that is there is that which one is better, Covaxin or Covishield?
If you ask
how
me,
how should we choose?
I'll show you two fingers. Touch one of the fingers and go ahead.
No, it's like how should we choose? That's a question.
Here, so, the point is, they may read a report in WhatsApp or somewhere. One is giving 84, the other is giving 81%. Statistically speaking, clinically speaking, that difference is null and void. They're same. Government of India would not have bought the idea without looking at the data. And we very clearly note that both the vaccines are equally good. When both the vaccines can be given in immunocompromised allergy patients also. They are not live vaccines. No live virus is being injected. Don't be under the impression that adenovirus, some other new virus is being added. It is only a dead cover of that, like a packing material is put inside, and that will be removed by the body in the next 24 hours. So to me, it doesn't make sense to say that this is better or that is better. Government of India is offering only one vaccine in one state usually, but some states like Tamil Nadu have an option of both. If whatever is offered by your healthcare provider, please have it.
Sir, another question is, a patient who is on chemotherapy, can they go for vaccine? When they
people
are
on chemotherapy for cancer?
Yes.
Yes, they are immunocompromised patients and they have to consult their oncologist. Maybe they would reduce the dose of the immunosuppressants, because some of the chemotherapeutic agents are immunosuppressants. They suppress the immunity and that will not generate enough antibody response. They will not have any adverse reactions or deaths or anything, but their ability to generate or mount the immune response is much lower if they are on chemotherapy or anti-tumor therapy or immunosuppressive therapy. And they need to consult with their respective oncologist or immunologist before they take the vaccine. One thing which will happen is it may not be as effective as in general public. Otherwise, there is no way.
Sir, someone has, hello, sir, are you there? So someone has asked, your first dose is 0.5 ml, second dose is 1 ml for COVID.
No. Both the doses are exactly the same. This is the trials they did like that. When they did the trial, adenoviral vaccine trial, they had 0.5, 1, first dose 0.5, second dose 1, first dose 1, second dose 1. They did the trial and finally they came out, but both doses will be of the same strength, same quantity, same quality. Everything is same.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Wonderful session.
Dr. Kailash has come back.
Yeah. I also went out, but there's a power cut here. We all
went out. Similarly, I had disconnected twice during that. It never happens in my talks, and first time it happened here. Yeah, good experience to keep some backup.
Yeah. We had quite a good audience.
We are finished all the questions.
Yeah, I know.
Dr. Kailash, if you have anything specific from your side,
I think
you can ask.
No, I think we've answered the entire armamentarium of questions for the COVID vaccine, but this would have removed all the myths which all our patients have. Maybe through the YouTube, it will reach a bigger audience and we should be able to satisfy all the needs of the patients.
I have 4 or 5 concluding points to make.
Okay.
Number one, taking COVID vaccine is a must for all of us. It's a must. It's not legally mandatory, but make it mentally, it is important and essential for you. Number two, taking COVID vaccine is a must for you. Number three, taking COVID vaccine is a must for you. These are the three conclusions, important conclusions. Why I tell you that? In COVID race, nobody wins the race until everyone wins.
Yes.
Here is a race where nobody wins the race until everyone wins. I'll tell you a story. There were 10 children. 2 of them are lame children. They cannot walk properly. So they had a running race. The other children thought, these 2 lame children, they will not be able to run faster. What they did? All the 8 children, remaining 8 children, they held the hands of the lame children and walked at their own, at the pace of the lame children, and made the 2 lame children also win the race. Means what? In a community disease like this, I am not all alone. my protection is important to me, my family, my contacts, and my community at large. And protecting myself is protecting everyone. And my protection is everyone's protection. This sort of community orientation, this sort of sarva manavata has to go into the mind of everyone. And the other important thing is SMS. What is SMS? S is social distancing, M is the mask, and S is the sanitization of the hands. These will stay because we don't know about the variants. We are bound to get some disease in spite of the vaccine, though it is milder, and we are bound to transmit the disease if we get the disease. For these three reasons, one, I can get variant disease. Two, I can get a milder disease, but I can still suffer. Three, I can transmit the disease without having the symptoms. For these three reasons, SMS is a must. That will continue. Okay, what are the three conclusions? I will take COVID vaccine. I will take COVID vaccine. We all will take COVID vaccine. No doubt about it. Which vaccine? No question. Between the two fingers, you touch one. Whichever you get it, you take it. As simple as that.
Thank you very okay. much. With a very positive note, we'll end this. And I request Ramana Murthy to just give a vote of thanks.
Thank you, Dr. Sarmaji. First of all, I should, from the core of the heart and on behalf of all the participants and panelists, thank Dr. Sarmaji for this enlightening session today. It has clarified all the doubts and myths all the participants have got. This has helped a lot in this present scenario, whether I will take the vaccine or not, what are the side effects, which vaccine I should take, and all these things has very nicely clarified. Then when he said that there are two things, I just started noting down the three important things. Then he said, taking vaccine is a must, taking vaccine is a must, taking vaccine is a must. That speaks the importance of everyone should take the vaccine in a very emphatic manner. And very, he's a walking encyclopedia, I can say. Even if this COVID-19, a new disease on the face of the earth, he has gone that deep into the matter and his vaccination, and he has clarified in such a beautiful manner. Our heartfelt thanks to him for sparing his valuable time and explaining to us in a very, very profound and simple way and touching the important things. So our heartfelt gratitude to him. Second, my thanks to our Kailash ji, who has so nicely organized conducted this program. And the main persons are Med Piper Technologies, who are very instrumental in conducting this program for the good of the community, for the welfare of the community. It's a very, very interesting and very, very, very important session. But for them, this program could not have been that lively. They have done all these things, the IT team of theirs and the organizing team. Mainly the panelists are also played their vital role. They have asked the very, very pertinent questions. Mrs. Surya Nair, the PR and communicator of this Med Piper Technologies, she has done the best thing. Then other panelists like K. Uma Anuradha, K. Ravi Kumar, Dr. Girija Ramamurthy, and last but not the least, Dr. Kailash, who have done everything in a doctor's forum also. Some of the technical questions they have asked, and Dr. Sarma has very nicely explained it. And all the participants, I should thank them on behalf of this team, the panelists and the doctor's team and the organizing team. But for them, this program would not have been successful. The 100 plus, even if not the main number, if each 100, one person takes to the message to 10 people, I think it is a big help for the community at large, for the society at large. And very wonderful session, very educative, informative session. And I thank one and all for this great opportunity given to me. And as a panelist also, we are thankful to the organizing team, especially Dr. Sarma and our Dr. Girija Ramamurthy Madam also. Spoke very nicely, and Dr. Kailash, as usual, I know him when I was in Chennai, very dynamic and very enthusiastic and very energetic doctor. And we thank everyone from the core of the heart, and we are a very wonderful session, and I pray the Almighty for having given this good opportunity. Thank you all.